Let's learn about database buffer cache. We know database buffer cache is part of your shared global area. This database buffer cache holds the data blocks that are read from the data files. That means the data blocks are read from the data files and they are stored in the database buffer cache. From here, the user can read the data. Okay, all the users who are concurrently connected to the instance can share the data block stored in this database buffer cache. That's good, right? Sharing is good. Yes, all the concurrent users can share this data blocks. For the first time, when an Oracle database user requires for a particular piece of data, it first searches the database buffer cache. If it finds here, then it returns the data to the user. If it finds the data in the database buffer cache, then it's called a cache hit. Suppose if the data is not found in the database buffer cache, then the Oracle database will read the data blocks from the data files and then store it in the database buffer cache. So if the data is found in the database buffer cache, then it's a cache hit. If the data is not found in the database buffer cache and it has to read from the data files, then it is a cache miss. And the total number of buffers is defined by the parameter db underscore block underscore buffer. And each size of the buffer is dependent on the parameter db underscore block underscore size. Okay? Only the most recently used blocks are stored in this database buffer cache. If Oracle needs to read more data blocks from the data files into the database buffer cache, and if there is no space in the database buffer cache, then the unused data blocks is flushed out from the database buffer cache, and the new copies of data blocks are stored in the database buffer cache. Okay? One point to remember is, if the user requests for data, the data has to be read from the data files into the database buffer cache before sending to the user. Remember that. It cannot directly read from the data files and directly send it to the user. Whenever the user reads, if the data is present in the database buffer cache, then Oracle will immediately return the data. If it is not found in the database buffer cache, it will read from the data files, store it in the database buffer cache, and then return the data to the user. Okay, remember this. And database buffer cache is one of the very important cache, because this is where your actual data is stored. Okay, when I say this is where the data is stored, this is where the data is stored temporarily. Okay?